Hi everybody, it's Adam with HeartValveSurgery.com, and I'm here today at the Heart Valve Summit in Chicago, Illinois. I'm happy to be joined by one of the program directors of the conference, in addition to the chairman of cardiothoracic surgery at Mount Sinai Medical Center. This is David Adams. Nice to have you here today.
Adam, good to see you again.
Yeah, and so as you may know, we're answering patient questions that were submitted at the website. And Dr. Adams, a question came in from Jim, and he writes, Adam, my echo says I have a systolic anterior motion of the chordae. What is the likely progression of that condition?
Okay, well, he's describing something that's not uncommon for mitral valve repair. The mitral valve, which is the valve that controls inflow from our lungs toward our pumping chamber, and then the aortic valve, which controls the outflow from our pumping chamber to our body, share a certain space in the heart. So they have a continuity so that these two valves in a certain three-dimensional plane interact with each other. And what systolic motion means is the heart squeezing is some part of the mitral apparatus, which should be closing and getting out of the way of the blood exiting the heart, is getting caught up in this turbulence that's going out, and that's why it's called systolic motion. A chordae is the structure that supports the leaflets of the mitral valve, much like a parachute. They're attached in the ventricle. Mm. So the chordae, which should be moving posteriorly and out of the way during systole, and systole is just the medical term for when the heart squeezes, if the chordae are partly in the outflow track as the heart squeezes, that can cause this phenomenon called systolic motion. I think the good news for this patient is that that's actually, at this point after a valve repair, if he's healthy enough to write us and ask us about it, that typically means that it's not causing a substantial problem. If you had systolic motion that was really critical, in most circumstances, that's recognized intraoperatively and dealt with. Minor chordal SAM is something that you can see, or systolic motion is something that you can see. And the good news is that we believe that in most cases, the ventricle remodels, and as the ventricle changes its shape, this condition resolves. So in fact, it's really not something that often progresses. I would say much more commonly it regresses.
Got it. Well, Jim, I hope that helped you learn a little bit more. I know it helped me. And Dr. Adams, once again, as always, thanks for taking the time to organize this incredible event and for all your continuous work to getting the cardiologists and the surgeons and the nurses and the PAs together to really enhance valvular therapy. The patients out there really appreciate what you're doing.
Thanks again for coming and supporting the meeting.
Yeah. Thanks.